What it do?
Took you so long, man. What it do, man? Hey, we back in this thing. We got King Bray back there. We got Q. We just hanging out. Hey, in this video, y'all gonna see is us going to check out 5 different day cabs. You know, we've been looking for a day cab for a few months, and this is just the footage of each truck and our journey, our adventure to go look at it, test drive it, you know, and just try to find the right truck that suits us. So we're gonna show each clip of each truck, and then after that, we'll break down the pros and the cons of each truck, and then, you know, y'all can help us decide or let us know what you think we should have got.
10 toes, that's my MO.
All right, y'all. Hey, we out here looking at a day cab and a trailer. I'm gonna go for the test drive with the guy, man. I'm gonna let Quan shoot some video, and we'll be back with y'all.
Yep. You gonna be trying to change them gears?
Huh?
I said you gonna be trying to change them gears.
Mama. Mama.
What?
Whenever, if he get this and we go, if he goes to the toes, go and get some toes, I'm coming. I don't care if it's the whole day, still coming.
Yep.
And guess what?
What?
Me and Billy climbed up a whole bunch of rocks.
Gotta get what? Don't jump in it.
Oh my God.
Stop for it splash on you. What if that's doo-doo?
What?
I said, what if that doo-doo and both of y'all dropped it?
Doo-doo, Bobby.
I'm talking about the one being had.
You said,
oh,
you
got it. Yep. Real quick.
I threw it like it was 2K. Swish.
Yeah. Does it sound like they're coming back? You hear it?
Mm-hmm. I hear like the clutch or
changing
something.
Changing the gears.
I'm going to try to throw it the hardest I can.
Yeah.
But if it doesn't, just turn this into a pool.
Mm-hmm.
Three, two.
Real, we gotta do your hair too. Don't touch them dogs.
Which one?
They coming their way. Right there, look. Right there. Stop, Real. Cause look, he running towards you.
You shift, you're saying the 1200 to 1500 range.
Yeah, somewhere in that range. You can speed shift them.
Yeah.
But you gotta be good. As hard as 10 speed.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been some years. I drove a dump truck in solid waste.
Yeah.
When we was taking, it wasn't even our truck. We were borrowing from another department.
Yeah.
And run a trailer to Hartwell from Athens.
Uh-huh.
And I drove that a couple times. Wouldn't say I was the greatest, but The concept don't really change. I know how to drive a stick car all day long.
Right. And I always start off in second and the
same. Yeah, I kind of did that in the yard right there. I went first and then I kind of stopped.
Yeah.
Damn near to a complete stop. Went in second and it was perfect.
That's them. Is that? Yeah. It is cold out here. Ooh. Jeez.
Jelly belly, jelly belly, jelly bear.
You look good, man. Look. Hey, look at the trailer. Look. Look real good, don't
it? Yeah. Now I want to go for a ride.
Yeah, we're not doing that.
Why?
Because he just showing your daddy the truck.
I asked daddy. He said, we'll see.
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know, Ben. Watch out. Pretty nice.
Hey.
What y'all think about that?
Oh. No, what you think about it?
Look,
they ride good, man.
Look at this.
We can hear y'all
too. Yep.
Daddy.
Oh, you got some pups. What's up? What's up? You got some pups. Hey.
Yeah, we did.
Man. Telling y'all, man, golly, man, this will take me to the next level. He already said he wished these ramps were longer, so we would probably take it to WWF and let them weld up some longer ramps. These are like, what, 4 feet maybe? Maybe do some 6 or 8 feet ramps. But 35-ton trailer, Freightliner Columbia 2004, 10-speed Eaton, man, airbags. It's only single axle, man, but for the price, for the truck and the trailer, man, it cannot be beat. I don't want to reveal just yet, because I don't know if I'm going to post this video before I buy it or save it to when we actually buy it. Who knows? But regardless, y'all say prayers for KJ, man, for if we can get this thing, man.
We're in this thing.
Wow.
I like it.
It rolled good.
Did it?
Yeah. It rolled good, man. Went through all the gears. Looks good. I can only imagine it with a good fresh wash.
Oh, yeah. You can let
me move something with it. All right. We'll go holler at him, man. Talk about it some more and see what's up. Wish us luck. He's taking Ben for a stroll. Look at him, y'all. Ben like that kind of stuff. I want to get it too. You gotta harness that stuff, man. You gotta harness that that drive and that enthusiasm in a kid. Play with skid steers and excavators and stuff, man. Harness it. By the time he get out of school, shoot, what? He'd be ready to rock. Yes, sir, man. I got to have it, though. Me and Quan gonna go over here and talk it over. When he come back, we're gonna see if we lock in a deal. But, man, exciting, man. Exciting times.
somebody over there. Yeah, having fun with the dogs. I gotta get my baby girl a dog. Look at Ben. Look at Ben. Show y'all the engine. That big cat C13. Pretty nice and clean. It's a big old engine to it. $893,000. Just hit it. Look at the inside, man. It ain't all ragged out. Been inspected, passed DOT inspection on the truck and the trailer in February. I don't know if y'all can hear it in my voice, man. I'm excited, man. Damn if I can get this thing for a good price. Take 10 toes down to the next level. Gotta take a picture of this engine for T-Baby. T-Baby said he wanted some pictures. We might got us a deal in place. What you think about it?
I like it.
She says she gotta learn how to drive it, y'all. Look at him. That's the perfect thing to go take her test in, for real, man. For real. Without having to borrow one from nobody. He got to use it for one of his employees to take their CDL test in within the next couple of weeks. And then after that, it could be ours. So I'm excited, man. Truck and trailer. What you think, man?
Don't get no better than that.
Ben, I was trying to get you to look at the camera when you was doing the, what's the name of that machine you was in?
Bulldozer.
Bulldozer. Ooh, he know about that. Yeah. What's your name? Okay. I hear that. All right.
You can see what I did to
your yard. All right, man. Y'all hope for the best. Wish for the best. Wish us luck. Hopefully we hit y'all back in a few weeks with a brand new purchase, man. All is y'all at home. Peace!
20 minutes later.
Now look who we just passed on the way home. I had to turn around. I went down the road, turned around, and came back. Another Freightliner Columbia. This one got a cat too. It's a 2007 right here. Got the aluminum wheels on it. Asking 15 for this bad boy. Wow. Kettle hook set up right there. I'm gonna put a phone call in and see how many miles in. Some info on it. Actually, it was unlocked. It's got 1,000,000 miles on it. The other one we were looking at has 827, something like that. But this one is pretty clean on the inside as well. CB radio. Wow. Gotta be fate, man. Something's telling me it's time. It's time to get in this bad boy. All right, he gonna come and crank it up, show me a little something about it. But this is same engine, y'all. It's like fate, man, I swear. Leave from looking at one and find another, literally, on the way home. That last one was an old Dominion truck, too. Look at that big boy right there. Yeah, it's nicer. It's 2 years.
He's missing this piece of his truck.
It's 2 years newer. No, it's 3 years newer, but it does have more miles. This one's got over a million miles on it. But it's nice. How's it going, man?
What's going on? I'm Brad, man.
KJ.
Nice to meet you, brother. How you doing?
All right, so that 2005 Freightliner had quite a few more positives than it did negatives. The positives were that it was a truck and trailer combination for $18,000. That was pretty good.
DOT inspected.
It passed DOT inspection on truck and trailer, so we would have been able to use it for her Class A CDL license test, which she has roughly about 8 months left to get it. So that was good. It had this was a positive and a negative. It's a single axle. So currently, if we run cars with it, it's short, and you know, that's good. But going forward, for what I have in my head about making money and hauling bigger loads, bigger everything, you know, you never want to be limited. So I've got plenty of trucker buddies that's been telling me to go tandem axle. You might as well go tandem right from the start, so you have no limitations. So that was a positive and a negative. The negative that I really didn't like was it didn't have no sounds. No CD player, no speakers. It was an old Dominion truck.
So you had to make your own music.
Yeah.
He loving music.
It wasn't going to be no music in that unless I got creative or...
Beatbox.
I don't know. I don't know if I could have cut a hole in the dash with the harness back there or not. I was a little scared, a little worried about that. But what else? Is that all the positives?
Yeah.
I mean, it was a nice truck, man.
Oh, yeah.
893,000 miles. It had a fresh clutch. The clutch had been replaced, and they had a lot of service records, and also they had a title for the truck and a title for the trailer.
Yep.
So that was in our top two for sure. That was definitely one of the better two out of the five. The pros with that 2007 Freightliner was that it had a stereo, it had like a $900 CB radio, it had aluminum wheels, which is my favorite. I love the aluminum wheels all the way around. I know it had them on the outside. The inside wheels might have been aluminum as well, but I can't remember. But the negatives were that it had over a million miles, and the engine had been rebuilt, but he didn't have no paperwork on it. He said a buddy did it or something like that, so that was a little skeptical. And he wanted $15,000 just for the truck, and like I said, it had over a million miles on it. So those were the pros and cons of that one. That truck was also a single axle, not a tandem. So I would say that one probably ranked in the bottom three. It's not a gym, it's a redskin.
You ready to cheat, baby?
I'm ready.
I'll be there.
Yes.
Move forward? You want to move the seat forward?
Go ahead.
You sure? I can move it forward.
Nah, I'm sorry. Man, we go. That plug is breaking.
Thank you.
window. How the hell you let the window down?
No, it ain't power. It may have a switch. It's probably got a switch over here to let that window down. You just got one on this side here.
It's all right. It's cool.
All right, which driveway I need to go out of?
This one.
Okay.
It's a 9-speed. What you think about a 9-speed?
9-speed, great.
Think about it, man.
We got another one of
the classics. Tandem Axle. Aluminum wheels all on it.
It's rich. I love it. But
it's got aluminum wheels on the inside and the outside, too. It needs some small stuff, man. It runs good, though. But it's got a broken step thing at the back. What? Detroit run good. That's a little stuff. A little stuff wrong with it. Speedometer don't work. It says 37. I'll tell y'all in a second.
Odometer showed 37,000 miles.
But when we test drove it, man, it didn't move. Speedometer didn't move. A couple of these gauges don't work, so ain't no way to really tell how many miles is on it. And Mr. T ain't got he didn't have the plug to plug into this one. This is a 95. He brought his laptop, but he didn't have the plug. But I mean, it ran good. It did run good. It had some good power. Just got some small things wrong with it, which anything will have small problems.
Radio up there.
Some of the gauges don't work. The air is in and out.
Good God Almighty. I'd have put a motor in it.
My driver's on
a
rod through the block on.
I don't doubt it. That
truck will
turn
well.
This
right here.
Yeah.
Dale
truck.
Wait a minute.
No.
I was thinking
about
it. Yeah, be welded back on.
Yeah.
Aluminum wheels in.
No, this is on. You said what happened? Loader,
yeah.
That's
they asking 15 for it. I think Quan offered 13, and I don't know. It just needs a little work. But like I said, everything does. So we'll see. We'll see. Tell me what y'all think.
All right, that 94 International. Well, it might have been 95 International. I can't remember. It had a few positives. I think it had more negatives. The positives was that it had 10 aluminum wheels. Y'all know I love my aluminum wheels. And it had the inners and the outers and the front. Everything was aluminum. That was pretty cool. The body style, that's one of my favorite body style trucks. I love those internationals. It was a tandem axle, not a single, so it would have been able to pull some serious weight. It had a Detroit 60 series 12.7. That was a big plus, man. That's the engine that I had been looking for this whole time I've been looking, was pretty much for a Detroit 60 series, and they're very hard to find. So I was happy that it had that. But the negatives, it was just mainly the speedometer and the odometer did not work. So you couldn't verify how many miles was on it. The odometer said 37,000. We are almost positive that was probably over a million. It probably turned the clock. Mr. T came with me, as y'all saw in the video. He looked at it and said the head had been off, meaning it's probably had some considerable work done to it. But without the speedometer, odometer working, you couldn't really verify nothing. The interior was kind of in shambles. The seats weren't really mounted all that well. Various gauges wasn't working. At the back of the truck, the back bar was damaged, or the back brace, I'm not exactly sure what they call it. It was damaged, and the spring mount was just busted all to hell. It needed to be, it had been welded before, and it had broke loose again. So we felt that it needed too much work to be road ready ASAP. And they had it listed for 15,000. I think they was gonna take 13.5. So, I would say that truck probably was in the bottom three. All right, y'all, we out here again looking at another truck. This is a Freightliner 2000 model. It's got a few imperfections, but got a big Cummins in it. 50 something foot trailer. Pretty nice, flip outs. Said electric over hydraulic disc brakes.
This one's got a little leak right here.
So the trailer's in a little rough shape, but it's still a properly functioning trailer. I had to do some wheel seals on that bad boy. Crank it back up.
You don't take very many trailers that you can
win. Inside fairly clean. It's probably got 1.2 million on it. Said it did an end frame on it. If the AC works, I don't think it does. The inside pretty nice though. I do like that. It's kind of dark, I don't know if y'all can see it. might need some aluminum wheels. And some little tidy work here and there. So you want $15,000 for this one, y'all.
Well, I can tell you 75
mile an
hour, but it don't matter
if it's loaded in. They pull them caterpillars out of state them
down there with it, or yeah. He put three of them on there and take off
to Alabama with it. Run
75 mile an hour.
Got airbags on it.
Airbags,
got a 7-pin plug, got a ball. Yeah, just got to put a new pipe on it for sure.
Yeah, it needs that elbow there. I mean, you want that? It's a green one. Oh, I know, buddy. I mean, you're driving around the parking lot.
All right.
I'm coming.
That ain't cold, man.
It is.
No, it ain't.
I feel
it's hot.
Cold. I feel cold in this.
Hey, the air conditioner get cold.
Got some serious power, man. For real. Who but you know who did all the engine work?
But it's that strong and loaded too. It's just like it loaded. That's like I was telling her. I mean, the $15,000 I'll take for it and the $2,500 I knocked off. I mean, you can spend $2,500 on it. And I won't be scared driving over.
They need a battery.
I gotta go show y'all this boost of power.
They might be a battery box around here.
Come on, y'all. Let's see this. Look at that, that thing is boosted. And, bruh, y'all should see this thing. This thing is boosted too. Holy, this thing is boosted and it's a drag truck. Y'all, I know y'all see that. I know y'all see that. Look. This is gonna be the thumbnail. Wait, y'all, this is gonna be the thumbnail. Actually, this ain't. I don't think it will be the thumbnail. But, another one. This might be the thumbnail. I think this thing's gonna be the thumbnail. We just wanted to check it. I just wanted to show y'all of my mom driving. Peace.
All right, so that 2000 Freightliner, the green and white one with the truck and the trailer, that was a pretty nice unit. Man, that engine had some serious power. Bray wasn't with us when we went and looked it out. That was just me, Quan, and Ben. But that thing had some serious power. I want to say that was a 10-speed, if I remember correctly. But yeah, it was a single axle, so if you was to haul cars with it, it was short. You can get in and out of places real good. And the price was pretty decent. He told us he would take $15,000 for it. But I think that was all the positives, man. That truck had more negatives for sure. The main thing was the trailer was terrible. The trailer was junk. It was a car trailer. Probably could use and get some use out of it, but it was horrible if you really looked at it. And the mileage on the truck, I don't even remember what it was, but it was fairly high. He didn't know the history on it. I think he said somebody had rebuilt it, or whoever had it before him rebuilt it. But that was about it. I mean, it was a good setup. Price was okay. I was in the mind frame that I would probably sell the trailer. That was the big thing. He did not have a title for the trailer. He had a title for the truck, but no title for the trailer. Now, in Georgia, you can't get a tag for something for a trailer that's over 2,000 pounds without a title. So he had told me some things that it had a state given bill of sale or some nonsense. I didn't want to deal with that because I've bought a trailer that didn't have a title and I already been down that road, so that was a negative for me. But that truck and trailer probably could have been, well, the truck probably could have been put to use right away, but I was scared about the trailer and probably wouldn't have been able to sell it without a title, so that kind of worried me. But I would say that one was probably in the bottom three just for having the title issues. I know a lot of y'all probably think, man, that's a pretty good setup, but that trailer was pretty bad. And the truck had some issues. The muffler pipe, the elbow on the muffler was rotted out. But man, that thing had some serious power. So that interests me because it would move. But all in all, that truck was in the bottom three as well. All right, look, y'all. We out here at Oconee County Fleet Department. They're selling this truck. Seen it on the auction. Not this Sterling right here. That would be a nice one to have. I think it's this old Ford over here. Tandem axle with a Cummins N14, man. Gonna check it out and see if it's worth pulling the trigger on. N14 is supposed to be a damn good motor. Let's see here. Grill is all there. Needs a paint job for sure. Look at the back tires, man. All right, so look. Tank on one side. Amazing tires. Airbags. This thing is pretty nice. Right now, the bid is at like 9,200. So I have to see what it actually goes down to, what it goes up to. But trying to grab it, man. Everything I've read about the N14 is supposed to be a beast. Let's see if we can get this mother big heavy something up. Whew. That heavy. Whew. Oh yeah. It's a big boy right there. Got a little oil leak down here. Belts on it. My boy Jarvis actually drove this truck for some years. So kind of know the history on it. Manual windows. It's got it eaten. Inspection form. Accurate. It's a manual 13 speed.
That's it for the crank. Right now.
sure is. Call Mr. T. I gotta call Mr. T and let him know what I'm seeing out here. See if he want me to check for anything. All right, y'all. Check the oil. Oil stick look good. No blow by. Look at that. No blow by. AC working. Y'all know what the tires cost in the back here. You probably looking at $200 a piece, if not more. It's been a while since I bought tires at Solid Waste. I don't know what they're going for, but. All eight, man. All eight. Look damn brand new.
I'm tripping on this AC, man.
It's ice cold in here. Yes, sir.
I can see myself in this mug, man.
Mr. T said this 13 speed is what you want. He said that's a hell of a transmission. But we're going to try to get it, y'all. Auction ends in about 3 hours, I think. Yeah, man. Wow. We need this at 10 toes down. Wow. Y'all pray for me. I know y'all ain't gonna see this. It's gonna be over by the time y'all see this, but still, you can't never have enough prayers, man. Y'all pray for 10 toes down, man. We're gonna holler at y'all later on.
All right, so the Ford. I found that on the Gov deals, but it was a local truck. It was at Oconee County Roads Department. It had 310,000 original miles, man. That is, that's not even broke in for a diesel, really, you know? And, the main positive was that it had an N14 Cummins. As I told y'all earlier, man, my search started out, I was looking for Detroit 60 series, 12.7 or 14 liter. And that's kind of, I had tunnel vision. That's all I was looking for. Well, as I kept looking, I kept hearing about N14, I kept doing research and apparently it's a pretty stout motor. So that truck had an N14, 310,000 original miles. It had a 13 speed transmission, which a lot of people told me is really good. That's what you want to have. It was a tandem axle. So it was able to, you know, pull some serious weight if need be. And me, like I said, forecasting out for the future, that's something I want to do, man. I want to pull excavators and bigger things that make more money on shorter runs or less runs. I don't personally want to do cars all the time, you know, so that was a big factor. Another positive was Mr. Tyner has worked on that truck several times. Whenever the that local government's fleet department couldn't fix something, they took it to Tyner and he would fix it. And he said it was a great truck. Now, the main kicker was my buddy used to work at that government in that department. And he used to drive that truck for 5 years while he worked there. He said that truck never struggled to move anything they put behind it, and it rarely had any issues. And if it did have an issue, that fleet department would take care of it immediately. Let me see, that's all the positives, I think. We knew the history on it, knew who drove it, had the Cummins N14, had low mileage. I can say another positive was the looks. It looked like a pretty good truck, you know, older. Might command some respect going down the road, maybe, who knows. But the negatives was it was on an auction. So there was no way to tell how much the auction was gonna be. But yeah, that truck, it didn't really have, the only negative I could say was it was a tandem. you know, but that's a positive and a negative depending on which way you look at it. So, yeah, I would say that was definitely one of the top two trucks, that one and the Freightliner with the flatbed trailer. We got Quan coming back out here. So, with that being said, you've seen all five. Drop down in the comment and let us know which one you would have picked. Which one would have been better for our operation now or going forward? Which truck you would have got? You know, drop down and let us know what you think. And
what's the better fit as far as me taking my test?
Yeah, and let us know what y'all think, man. Till next time, we're gonna holler at y'all later on.
Peace.
Peace.